be sure you introduce the candidate today. God bless you all.
Amen. Thank you. Thank you. I love that song. Well, Steve Lambrose told me there'd be ice cubes and tadpoles in here, so it's not. I want to say, first of all, how much I appreciate Pastor Paul that you've let us be here. I didn't have to shop around for a church when I heard I was going to be baptizing somebody. We needed a pool. I thought of this place first. I just knew we'd be welcome here. Second thing is, and I relish this opportunity to tell this church, that you have been a tremendous blessing to me. You have poured into me because you have poured into Steve Lambrose. You have raised him up in Christ, and Steve has poured into my life. He's been a tremendous blessing to me. So I owe you a debt of gratitude just for that. Come on down, Brother Alex. This is Alex Mercer. We're going to let him testify in a minute. I want to read a scripture to you. Okay, we believe in believer's baptism.
Amen.
Believer's baptism. That's important. That's an important doctrine. And I know that we agree on that doctrine for sure. Believer's baptism. Some people on the day of Pentecost, after Peter had preached to them and said, you people have crucified your own Messiah. And they said, oh, What can we do? And he said, and Peter said unto them, repent. Repentance is necessary for baptism. Repent and be baptized, every one of you, in the name of Jesus Christ for the remission of sins.
Amen.
And ye shall receive the gift of the Holy Ghost. That's a promise. That's a promise. That's believer's baptism. Romans 6:4 says, therefore, we are buried with him, buried with Christ Jesus. We're buried with him by baptism into his death. That life as Christ, that is just like Christ, raised up from the dead, how? By the glory of the Father. It's all about the glory of the Father.
Amen.
Even so what? Even as Christ was raised up by the glory of God, even so, we also should walk in newness of life. It is my blessing and my privilege to introduce to you Alex Mercer, my dear friend and brother in Christ. I want to hear his testimony, what the Lord has done for him, and then we'll enter into this baptism.
Well, I admit, yesterday, when this changed from being a small, intimate setting with just a few bands of brothers to a large crowd in a church I don't know, a season of fear and nervousness swept over me. I had a conversation with God last night about that, and I said, I'm just going to have to put out the fleece, God. If I wake up in the morning, I know it's your will to be here. So I woke up, and here I am. I grew up here in Wilmington, just a couple miles down the road. Always lived in North Carolina. I grew up in a godly family, a loving family. I opened the Bible and read it openly. Went to church often. And as a young man, a youth, I accepted Jesus Christ. Well, I had 100% faith in the Bible in my mind. But it took years, even decades, for that to manifest and move into my heart. The biggest reason was my heart. And the biggest tool the devil used was dependency on alcohol. A shackle, a chain. It gave you darkness. And that darkness made my pursuits into gods that were more important than the living God. Dishonored his name. I've dishonored his Sabbath. I've dishonored my parents. And my sins convicted an innocent man and put him on a cross at Calvary. And the Bible says even a wandering lustful eye dishonors the covenant with a man and a woman. I've stolen. I've lied. I've coveted. I simply had self-centeredness, loving myself more than God or you. But you can take those shackles off by giving your life over completely to the care and will will go anywhere, any place, anytime to talk to anybody about how you can take a shackle off of an addiction by turning your life completely over to the will and care of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Amen.
Even the secular heathens believe that. And what does that mean? I'm only here, not because of works, because only of the testimony I can give of what I believe. I believe in God, the living God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. God, the Father, creator of the world. Jesus Christ, his Son, only Son. And no one can go to the Father through him. I believe the Holy Spirit and his indwelling. I believe in the Trinity as one Godhead. I believe in the redemption of the saints because of the blood shed on Calvary by the innocent man murdered as a man sinless who rose 3 days later as my God, my Savior, my King, my Lord, my Redeemer. I believe in the communion of saints. I believe in the fellowship of the believers. I believe Jesus Christ is at the right hand of the Father and come back to claim the saints. I believe I'm a sinner only saved by the grace and mercy of God. I believe in the Bible, and I believe it's true, word for word, cover to cover. I believe that God, the Bible is God talking to me personally, and therefore I endeavor to open my head with diligent study, my heart with meditation and memorization, and my life by obeying its teaching, and in this world by my witness. And here I will be the same. Never. I'm going to love God with all my mind, heart, and soul.
Amen.
I'm going to love you as my neighbor better than myself and be willing to serve you. I'm going to rise up and be the priest, the provider, the protector of my home that my wife, Jenna, deserves. To be the godly man my family needs. To be full in submission to God's will and follow him fully to
Amen.
The uttermost ends of the world.
Amen.
So the day I come, baptism as a statement of my profession of Christ, as a representation of the fire, baptism of fire, the Holy Spirit indwelling. I come home to thank you.
Alex's mother, Mrs. Mercer's right there. If you just raise your hand so they know you're there. Steve Lambros and Bill Cooper, Dr. Bill Cooper, certainly witness to this and can be witness to you of the authenticity of what this brother has been saying. I've watched God do some pretty amazing things in this guy's life.
Amen.
And I expect to see more. All right, my brother. Lord God, thank you for Alex. We pray, Lord, that you just continue to grow in him, to dwell here and have your will through this servant of yours. And now, Lord, as a minister of Jesus Christ, I baptize this, my brother, in obedience to the gospel of Christ, in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Hey Alex, I want you to know I just can't wait to hear you when you're not nervous. When you're ready to speak to us. And you're one of those family members. I'm proud to have you as my brother. Thank you.